sanitizer before going up for communion, and please wait to be dismissed at the end of the Mass by our hospitality ministers, just so that we can keep everybody extra safe and distance. Our presider today is Father Dominic, assisted by Deacon Stan. Please stand now and greet those around you before we begin. As always, all of our music can be found on your orders of worship, so please join in singing as you feel able. Gather us in.
Now is the darkness vanished away. See in this space our fears and our dreamings, brought here to you by the light of this day. Gather us in the lost and forsaken. Gather us in the blind and the lame. Call to us now and we shall awaken. We shall arise at the sound of our name. We are the young, our lives are a mystery. We are the old who yearn for your face. We have been sung throughout all of history, called to be light to the whole human race. Gather us in, the rich and the haughty. Gather us in, the proud and the strong. Give us a heart so meek and so lowly. Give us the courage to enter the song.
Good afternoon. Welcome to this celebration of God's love. In a very special way, I want to welcome a beautiful couple who is celebrating their 50th wedding anniversary. Rutilio and Maria Luisa Barilla. I love these Polish names. I struggle so much, and with this one, no problem. These are beautiful Polish. So keep it up, okay? 25 more years, we celebrate again, okay? That's good. With gratitude in our heart, we begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. The grace, peace, and joy of God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
How many times did you and I allow ourselves to be deceived by something that is shining only to realize it has no value? It doesn't bring me happiness. What a letdown. And right next to me, perhaps, there was something, someone saying, open your heart to me. For the times that we have allowed ourselves to be deceived, we ask for forgiveness.
You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten of the Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit, the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, protector of those who hope in you, without whom nothing has firm foundation, nothing is holy, bestow in abundance your mercy upon us, and grant that with you as our ruler and guide, we may use the good things that pass in such a way as to hold fast even now to those that ever endure. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the first book of Kings. The Lord appeared to Solomon in a dream at night. God said, "Ask something of me, and I will give it to you." Solomon answered, "O Lord my God, you have made me your servant, king to succeed my father David. But I am a mere youth, not knowing at all how to act. I serve you in the midst of the people whom you have chosen, a people so vast that it cannot be numbered or counted. Give your servant, therefore, an understanding heart to judge your people and to distinguish right from wrong. For who is able to govern this vast people of yours?" The Lord was pleased with Solomon, who had made this request. So God said to him, "Because you have asked for this, not for a long life for yourself, nor for riches, nor for the life of your enemies, but for understanding so that you may know what is right, I do as you requested. I give you a heart so wise and understanding that there has never been anyone like you up to now. And after you, there will come no one equal to you." The word of the Lord.
Your commands, Lord, I love your commands. My part I have resolved, O Lord, is to obey your word. The law from your mouth means more to me than silver and gold. Lord, I love your commands.
let your love be ready to console me by your promise to your servant. Let your love come and I shall live, for your law is my delight. Lord, I love your command. That is why I love your command more than finest gold, why I rule my life by your precepts and hate false ways. Lord, I love your commands. Your will is wonderful indeed, therefore I obey it. The unfolding of your word gives light and teaches the simple. Lord, I love your commands.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, we know that all things work for good for those who love God, who are called according to his purpose. For those he foreknew, he also predestined. He predestined to be conformed to the image of his Son, so that he might be the firstborn among many brothers and sisters. And those he predestined, he also called. And those he called, he also justified. And those he justified, he also glorified. The word of the Lord.
Blessed are you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth. You have revealed to the little ones the mysteries of the kingdom. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "The kingdom of heaven is like a treasure buried in a field, which a person finds and hides again, and out of joy goes and sells all that he has and buys that field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant searching for fine pearls. When he finds a pearl of great price, he sells all that he has and buys it. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a net thrown into the sea, which collects fish of every kind. When it is full, they haul it ashore and sit down to put what is good into buckets. What is bad, they throw away. Thus it will be at the end of the age. The angels will go out and separate the wicked from the righteous and throw them into the fiery furnace, where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth. Do you understand all these things? They replied, yes. And he replied, then every scribe who has been instructed in the kingdom of heaven is like the head of a household who brings from his storeroom both the new and the old. Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
For those of you who don't know me, I'm Deacon Stan Lowe, temporary parish director for 6 more days, I think. I have really good news, and that is that Father Brian has made an excellent recovery, and we'll be back next weekend. So our prayers have been answered. So today's gospel raises the question of how good are we at recognizing something of great value? I know that's kind of a popular thing to these days. How many of you go to rummage sales? Go to rummage sales? A few of you. And what are you looking for? You're looking for a deal, right? You're looking for something that you can use, something that you would like at a good price. And there's TV shows like that, right? There's pawn TV shows, there's junk collector TV shows, and everybody there is looking to find a diamond in the rough, to find something of great value that they can get for a good price. And that's kind of what the parables in today's gospel are about. They're quite short, really, but with the 4 preceding parables, they show us really how important it was for Jesus to help us to understand the truth about himself and his kingdom. The parable of the buried treasure and the parable of the pearl of great value draw upon the experience of uncovering something that's hidden or discovering some new thing. It's like the stories that we occasionally hear about somebody going to a rummage sale and buying a priceless masterpiece painting, and they got it for just a few bucks, right? Or perhaps more in tune with most people's lives, the joy that we might experience when we find something that we thought we had lost and we didn't know if we were ever going to find it. We find it and we're happy. These parables speak to the aspect of human nature that wants us to seek and find new things and new experiences. And we probably all had that, right, where we try something new and we love it, but it kind of loses its luster over time. Or we get that new car, and after a while, we want another new car. And some people, we go through life and time and again, and eventually, hopefully, we find out that while it's nice getting those things, that they're not going to bring us any real joy. And those that are fortunate among us, and I hope that we all fit in that category, discover at some point that the only true source of joy is Jesus. Going back to the parables for a minute, the man in the field. Why does he find the treasure and then bury it again? Because it wasn't his field. In order for the treasure to be his, he had to own the field. So he buried the treasure again. And then we are told that he did something really radical, if you think about it. He sold everything that he had to buy that field to obtain the treasure. In a spiritual sense, his decision is kind of like a person that decides to renounce their old way of life for the pursuit of the only thing that's really good, perfect, and holy, that is Jesus Christ. And the same logic follows for the story of the merchant and the pearl. But then what about this third parable that's so different from the other two? The first, they're really happy, right? They're happy. He finds a treasure, finds a pearl. Boy, this one is different, right? It's kind of a harsh departure from the joy expressed in those first two. I mean, what does the final judgment and the fiery torments of hell, what do they have to do with finding Jesus Christ and his kingdom? They have to do this. Each one of us has at some point in our life to choose between Jesus and the passing joys of this world. And once we make that choice, we have to act accordingly. It's not enough just to say it. We have to do it. There's no room for compromise, and there is no time to waste. We're all going to die someday, and any one of us could die at any moment. So we can't say, well, I'm going to do it tomorrow, because we might not have a tomorrow. And while it is Christ who will separate the sheep from the goats, we ourselves are the ones that really write the final ending of our stories through the choices that we make during our lives here on earth. And then finally, the question that Jesus asked his disciples have asked is also asked of us today. Do you understand all these things? If the answer is yes, then we will know that there is only one thing of true lasting value and that we must do everything we can to attain it.
Please stand, and together we renew our faith in this God who should be the hidden treasure buried in the field. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and of his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us ask not for ourselves alone, nor seek material blessings only, but lift up to the Lord our God the deepest needs of all the earth.
That the Church may cast a wide net, embracing people of every kind, leaving the separation of good from evil to God and to God's own time. We pray. That counselors and therapists may be wise and discerning to help people move toward recovery. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have been made ill by the coronavirus, and for all who care for them, and for the governments and people of the world, that we may experience the healing mercy of the Lord. We pray.
Lord, hear my prayer.
That world leaders will have the wisdom to see that the greatest treasure is human life itself, and may work to protect and enhance that gift, we pray.
Lord, hear my prayer.
That in accepting one another and celebrating our diversity, we may be conformed more perfectly to the image of Christ, who is the firstborn among many brothers and sisters, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the dead whom God called to faith and justified in baptism, especially Janice Cotter, may now be glorified according to God's purpose, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For James Majeska, whom we remember in today's Mass, and in the celebration of Rutilio and Maria Luisa Berea's 50th wedding anniversary, which we celebrate today, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the prayers written in the prayer book and on the prayer chain, and for those held in the silence of our hearts, we pray.
Father, hear the prayers of your church and grant us the gifts and graces which we ask for with faith. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Sisters and brothers, let us pray that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the offerings which we bring from the abundance of your gifts, that through the powerful working of your grace, these most sacred mysteries may sanctify our present way of life and lead us to eternal gladness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us, the Redeemer, to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as in exaltation we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jerome, our Bishop, the clergy, and all of your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, St. Charles Borromeo, St. Roman, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us pray together for the coming of the kingdom as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith, hope, and love of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are we, invited to the banquet of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word of my soul. The body of Christ. 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 The body of Christ.
Love.
Let us pray. We have consumed, O Lord, this divine sacrament, the perpetual memorial of the passion of your Son. Grant, we pray, that this gift, which he himself gave us with love beyond all telling, may profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. Now I would like to invite Rutilio and Maria Luisa to please come up here. And I invite each one of you to raise your right hand as we call upon them God's blessings. You can hold hands. Almighty and eternal God, you have so exalted the unbreakable bond of marriage that it has become the sacramental sign of your Son's union with the Church as his spouse. Look with favor on Rutilio and Maria Luisa, whom you have united in marriage 50 years ago. As they ask for your help and the protection of the Virgin Mary, they pray that in good times and in bad, they will grow in love for each other, that they will resolve to be of one heart in the bond of peace. Lord, in their struggles, let them rejoice that you are near to help them. In their needs, let them know that you are there to rescue them. In their joys, let them see that you are the source and the completion of every happiness. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. You may kiss the bride. Thank you. Congratulations. Be sure to invite me for your 60th.
Okay.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
As we go forth in great joy, please join in singing as you feel able. Sing a new song.
A new song unto the Lord. Let your song be sung from mountains high. Sing a new song unto the Lord, singing Alleluia. Shout with gladness, dance for joy. Oh, come before the Lord and play for God on glad trombones. Then let your trumpet sound. A new song unto the Lord. Let your song be sung from mountains high. Sing a new song unto the Lord, singing Alleluia. Rise, O children, dance from your sleep. Your Savior has come. He has turned your sorrow to joy and filled your soul with song. A new song unto the Lord. Let your song be sung from mountains high. Sing a new song unto the Lord, singing Alleluia.